and girls, on Sunday, I think everybody knows that it's Mother's Day. And so I thought I would do a craft for Mother's Day. But I also know that nobody can go out and buy any supplies to make anything. So I thought I would try and make something that you could do with whatever you have at home. The first thing, let me show you what the end result is going to look like. I want to make a Happy Mother's Day card. And on the card, we're going to have a flower on the front, and then on the inside, you will write Happy Mother's Day, love, and your name on the bottom. And I thought that because this is a very special year, that you would put the year on the bottom, and if Mom puts it in her memory box, she will know that it came the year of the virus. Now, to make the card, that's the easy part. You can get a piece of white paper, or you could even use something that has print on one side. You would just like to make the card be the white part of the paper. You're going to fold it in half, and then fold it in half again, so that you have this. And what I did with the flower was, I put it this way, so that it would fit nicely. I also noticed that it would fit this way as well. So that's the card itself. Now, because I know that you probably don't have colored paper at home like we have here at the library, I thought you could make the parts of the flower yourself with crayons. And to make the circle, I'm using a toilet tissue roll. And I cut one whole row in half so that it would be easier for you to hold it down on the paper and trace around it. Now, I'm going to use crayons today because I figure that you all have crayons at home. If you have markers at home, that would be good also. But a lot of people don't have markers, but the crayons will do just fine. You do need to use something that's dark to trace around the toilet tissue roll. So you'll put the toilet tissue roll on the paper and trace right around it. And it won't matter if your circle is not exactly great, because then you're going to cut it later anyway. Okay, I already drew a few. Then you're going to take the colors that you want, and I used purple, a dark pink, a blue, an orange, and a red crayon. Now you could also make your flower all the same color with a yellow center. I happen to do all different colors. So you're going to take your crayon and just color in however you want. It doesn't have to be neat, as long as it covers the circle. And so you're going to do that with each of your crayons. So I've done purple, and now I'm doing orange. You can do blue. The reason why I used a black crayon to draw the circle is because a color as dark as blue makes it difficult for you to see the rest, the black line when you're getting ready to cut. Okay, so now I've done almost all the colors. And you will just cut them out as best you can. Don't worry about them being even or straight or anything like that, because it won't matter, because they're going to go right on top of each other on the card. You can do it as neatly and as nicely as you'd like. It doesn't have to be exact. Just try and cut so that you don't see the black line, so that when you put the flower together, it doesn't have any black lines. It just has the colors of the petals showing. Almost done. But of course, you don't have to use the colors that I used. You can make it all one color, as I said. So now what we're going to do is going to glue it onto the card. And as I said, mine opens from the bottom up, and I just put glue on the back of each color and glued it down one after the other, however you want to arrange them. And you can put them close together, you can put them far apart, you can take up the whole front of the card if you want. And then I always save the yellow for the center. So there you are. And you'll open it up and you'll write your message as I did on the inside. Happy Mother's Day, love, and sign your name on the bottom. And like, I'll just remind you, put 2020 so that when Mom opens it up next year, she'll remember that she got it from you this year. Now, if you don't want to make a card out of it and you just want to make a picture, you can take those circles, make your flower on a big piece of paper, and then use a green crayon and make a stem and do your Happy Mother's Day on the bottom wherever you want to. Okay, I hope that you enjoyed doing this. I hope everybody has a happy Mother's Day.